In this video, I'll show you how to use MATLAB to integrate ODEs. MATLAB can integrate one or more first-order ODEs. We'll first learn how to integrate a single first-order ODE. Then we'll learn how to integrate a system of two first-order ODEs. It's easy to generalize to any number of first-order ODEs. And remember, an nth-order ODE can be written as a system of n first-order ODEs. We'll start by integrating a first-order ODE. We'll solve the logistic equation, dx dt equals rx times 1 minus x, with r a parameter. We'll use the MATLAB function ode45.m to integrate the ODE. I'll explain the syntax as we code the problem. OK, let's try it in MATLAB. I'll do the coding in the live editor. The logistic equation is dx dt equals rx times 1 minus x. R is a parameter. We start by defining the right-hand side. So we set the variable dx dt to an anonymous function. So it will be at x comma r. X is the dependent variable of the differential equation. R is the parameter. And the function, the right-hand side, is r times x times 1 minus x. In the next line, we can set all the parameters that we need. So we set r equal to 1. We need to specify an initial condition for x to be able to integrate the differential equation. We set the initial condition x naught to a small value. We can't choose 0 because then dx dt will equal 0. So 0 is what's called an unstable fixed point. But we can set x naught to a small value. So we choose 0.01. And then t span then will be the initial t value, which we call to be 0, and a final t value, which we take to be 10. You can play around with the final value so you get a plot that looks nice. At this point, we're ready to call ODE45. So we do that. Let me discuss the right-hand side first. So ODE45 is expecting a differential equation with a right-hand side that has a t, which is the independent variable, and an x, which is the dependent variable. So you always need this at t comma x if it's a differential equation for dx dt. And then our right-hand side is coded in this function dx dt, and then that is a function of x and r. So this x here has to match this x here, but if your differential equation, the right-hand side has no t in it, then you don't need a t in this function. And you can put parameters here. So here we have the parameter r. So the first argument of ODE45 specifies the differential equation that you're solving. The second argument tells you which values of the independent variable you want to solve for. So t span with two components tells you the initial value of t, which is 0, and the final value of t, which is 10. The final argument is the initial condition x naught. Okay, so ODE45 will integrate the differential equation, and the solution then will be put into t comma x. These are vectors, column vectors. T is a column vector of the times that you have the solution of x for, and then x are those solutions. So t and x are two column vectors of the same length. You don't specify the points that you're integrating the that you're using in the integration. ODE 45 determines that for you. Okay, so at this point we're ready to plot. So let me put in all of the plot commands. We plot x versus t, so we call plot t comma x, and then we just label the plot to make it look nice. Okay, let's run. Here is our solution. We can open the window and we see the solution to the logistic equation. So it starts at some small value and then asymptotes to 1. We see that the choice of time from 0 to 10 gives a very nice S-shaped curve. The MATLAB function ODE45.m is a powerful tool for integrating differential equations. Now let's look at integrating a system of first-order equations. We'll solve two coupled first-order ODEs. These equations are called the Lotka-Volterra equations, or the predator-prey model. X is the prey, and Y is the predator. We have dx dt equals rx times 1 minus y, and dy dt equals 1 over r times y times x minus 1. Again, we include r as a parameter. We'll also learn how to solve this system using ODE45.m. Okay, let's try it again in MATLAB. So let's solve the Lotka-Volterra equations in the live editor. We have a system of two first-order equations. It's easier to code this up in a subfunction, so let's do it that way. Let's start with the subfunction. So I'm going to define a function dxy dt. That's by LV of xy comma r. So xy is the x and y dependent variables, and r then is the parameter. So in this function then, in order to match our equations, I'm gonna assign x to the first component of this xy vector. Xy is going to be a two-component vector. So x is the first component and y is the second component. And then I need to write down the right-hand side of the differential equation. And I do that here. So dxy dt is going to be a two-component column vector. It needs to be a column vector. So that's why there's this semicolon here. The first component is the first differential equation, so r times x times 1 minus y. And the second component is the right-hand side of the second differential equation, which is 1 over r times y times x minus 1. So dxy dt specifies the right-hand side of the two differential equations. Must be a column vector. Okay, so we've specified the differential equation. Now we can go back to the main script. Let's first set the parameters. So we set the R parameter equal to 1. We set the initial conditions for both X and Y. I said X initial condition to be 1.1 and y initial condition y naught to be 1. This is because I know what the solution looks like. If you're solving this for the first time, you will try different initial conditions. And I set t span, the initial and final value of t, to 0 and 6 times pi, also because I know what I'm looking for. Okay, then we're ready to call the differential equation. So here we go. So let's look at the right-hand side first. So the first argument of ODE 45 is supposed to be the right-hand side of the differential equation. So we have at t, comma, xy. So xy then is now a two-component vector because we have two first-order differential equations. And the LV of xyr is our coded subfunction here. So xy then is assumed to be two components in this function. T-span, as before, is the initial to final value of t. And the initial condition here is x-naught, y-naught. So we're giving it a two-component vector. It can actually be either a row vector or a column vector. ODE 45 doesn't care. Here I give it a column vector of two initial conditions. The initial condition for x-naught and the initial condition for x and the initial condition for y. Okay, because ODE 45 sees two initial conditions, it's expecting that xy then is going to be a two component vector. On the output we have t, all the values of t at which we have found the solution, and we have xy here is then a two-column array where the first column will correspond to the solution for x and the second column will correspond to the solution for y. Okay, now we're ready to plot our figures. Let me give you all of that code at once. And we can step through it. So in the first figure, we're going to plot xy versus t. That means we're going to, xy is a two-column matrix. So the first column will be x, will be plotted against t. And the second column will be y, will be plotted against t. When we see that plot, then we can set the axis to make it look nice. So I've done this already. We can X label, Y label, and title. Then in the second figure, I want to plot the values of Y against the values of X. So we're plotting XY of colon comma 1, so that's the first column of xy, which corresponds to x, and xy of colon comma 2, that's the second column of xy corresponding to y. I clean up the plot by putting an axis specification and then a labeling. So let's run. This is our output. So the first plot here is x and y versus t, and our second plot here is y versus x. Okay, for a final note, we look at these plots and we may not be completely satisfied. If you look at xy versus t, for instance, if I zoom into the top here, you'll see that it's not very smooth, okay? So that has to do with the linear interpolation that's going on. So we should, of the solution points, so we should clean that up. If we look at this second plot, you'll see that there are overlapping curves here. The period of the Lotka-Volterra equation solutions should be 2 pi, and we have integrated to 6 pi, so we've integrated 3 periods. The solutions should be perfectly periodic, but here we see that the curves don't completely overlap. I mean, we can see that even more if we zoom in here, and we see these three curves that don't seem to be lying on top of each other. That's more than just an interpolation error. That's actually an error in the accuracy of our solution. And we're going to need to clean that up. So we'll look at these two problems in the next video. We've learned how to use ODE45.M to solve one, two, or even more first-order ODEs. Remember that any higher-order ODE can be written as a system of first-order ODEs. We still need to address the accuracy of our solution, and we'll do that next. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.